International Oceans Addenda in 2018 is receiving more attention than ever before. And for that reason, it is important that COFI remain in the forefront as the body that sets the global standards and policy development for international management of living marine resources. And equally importantly, that FAO as an organization remain the primary technical body to provide the advice and guidance to its member states and other stakeholders. At this particular meeting, we're focusing on a number of issues of critical importance, including the implementation of the guidelines for small-scale fisheries, combating IUU fishing, and looking at how to organize COFI in a way that makes the work of the organization more efficient and effective in better support of the priorities of its member states.
We have registered by now 760 participants, and this number continues to increase. In addition to many NGOs and other international organizations. This is the record of participants of all COFI sections in the history of FAO.
I'm very pleased to be here today at the 33rd session of the Committee on Fisheries at the FAO headquarters. I'm here to urge member states and those that have come to join in the committee's work over the next few days to observe the integrity of implementation of SDG 14. Four of the 10 targets of SDG 14 mature in 2020. So we don't have time. We have to get down to work now, and I'm here to talk to COFI on that subject today.
COFI Fisheries Trade is the main forum where all countries around the world deal with different issues related to trade, commercialization, consumers, and different issues on topics that are changing. All these issues that we speak about and go in depth during the subcommittee on fish trade has to be approved, has to be well known by the COFI itself.
You see, India has a very high stakes in the deliberations which take place in COFI, because India is not only one of the biggest players as far as fisheries and aquaculture is concerned globally, but a very large number of livelihoods also depend upon fisheries and aquaculture activities. And unlike most of the other countries, the size of fisheries and aquaculture in totality is big, but the holdings of individual farmers and fish workers are very small. So per person effort and the results of that effort are very, very meager. So we have very high stake that the global deliberations move towards sustainable fisheries, especially for the small scale sector.
COFI is the place where the world meets, really. All the fisheries and aquaculture in the world meet in this place. And what is very challenging is to understand the different perspectives and needs that every region and country has. This is where FAO takes a major role and puts everybody to work in a proactive way.
It's very important, the discussion around sustainability and Sustainable Goal 14 and eliminating illegal fishing and small-scale fisheries and the code of conduct, and all these is very important issues for Oman. Oman, as you know, is the first countries in the region to endorse the port state agreement, and we're proud of that, and we are the government's committed to implement its obligation by building capacity and by building the surveillance systems and by working with other countries.
The biggest challenge really we have is we don't have a cold chain facility throughout that long coast we have. So one of the things we are working on now is working with other international development partners and also other bilateral agreements to develop the cold chain facilities throughout the coast of Somalia. Because most people really now, whatever they produce is what they can consume. So there's no place to, you know, for storage. So that's one of the biggest challenges we are facing. But also equally, we are also really facing the problem of IUU or illegal fishing. It has been estimated, we don't have really good numbers, but we have seen different reports and different estimates that annually Somalia loses anywhere between $300 to $600 million annually, and that's a lot of really financial resources that is we are losing.
So this 33rd session of COFI has proven to be substantial. We have not just a significant level of attendees in the plenary, but we also have 14 side events dealing with issues from climate change to IOU fishing to transshipment at sea, issues that allow us to really develop our work program for the next 2 years in consultation with the member countries and the more than 200 observer organizations that are listening and are contributing to our deliberations.